Exceptional behavior and for us to build our relationships with our killer whales. Now blood samples are just one way that we can make sure that our whales are staying healthy. Another important diagnostic is weighing the whales. We weigh them every other week, and we're able to do that by asking them to slide their bodies up and out of the water onto a giant killer whale size scale that we have in one of our other pools. We'll demonstrate the slide out here. Makayo is our smallest whale. He weighs about 4,300 pounds. Right now you'll notice a portion of his body from his dorsal fin to his tail flukes is in the water. It's a very strong body part called its peduncle, and it weighs several hundred pounds, so without the water we wouldn't get an accurate weight. To solve that problem, we simply ask the whales to lift their tails up and out of the water. And this way, we can make sure that our younger whales continue to grow and our adult whales maintain a healthy body weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt, and for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales, and for us.
Observational learning and mimicry play a critical role in the life of a killer whale. From the moment they're born, they learn necessary life skills by watching and playing follow the leader with their moms and other whales, and our whales play follow the leader with us too. So we're going to put that to the test today with the entire left-hand side of the stadium. Everybody on the left-hand side, stand up! Up top two, stand up. We can see up there. Alright, what we're all going to do on the count of three, we're all going to spin around and see if Makayo can mimic us. Everybody ready? One, two, three, spin around in a circle. And you got it, all right, great job, guys. Very good, all right, have a seat, nicely done. So you can see here's paying very close attention to you. They're super curious animals. Our whales frequently can be seen spy hopping or even jumping completely out of the water to get a better look around. We'll demonstrate that over here on the left-hand side. This is a behavior that's called a spy hop. Okay, when Makayo does this jump, I want you all to give him a great big cheer. Here we go, he's on the bottom of the pool. In three, two, one. Ooh, all right, we're gonna take this part to the right-hand side. Now that was a pretty good jump that Makayo did over here, but we're gonna do one bigger and better over here with Trua. Now Trua is our largest whale. He weighs 6,600 pounds. He's coming from the back all the way down to the bottom of the pool. This is called a bridge. This is how killer whales can communicate with each other and make their presence known. Observation of the killer whales in our care has shed light on many of the mysteries about these amazing animals. For example, we know that the gestation period of a pregnant killer whale is about 17 months. That's information that would be impossible to obtain out in the wild. Some information, though, can only be gained through field observation. That's when SeaWorld works with our partners, like the Norwegian Orca Survey and NOAA, to further our knowledge. Killer whales are powerful animals. And perhaps the best example of that power that we've seen is when they hunt. But for all of you, it's time to get wet! they can eat several hundred pounds of food every day. In the wild, their diets vary depending on where they live and the time of year. Fortunately, overfishing, pollution, and other factors are having a serious impact on some killer whale populations.
Together, we've got this.